Everybody get your fucking hands up.
Hello guys, so this is the Chessmaster Grandmaster Edition game, and this is my first recorded game in the Chessmaster Grandmaster Edition game, and I am playing against a 1230 ELO points player. I'm playing against Orin. So Orin is one of the personalities in the Chessmaster Grandmaster Edition game. And we have this Queen Knight variation, and okay, let's play the... I'm going for the four knights defense, so we have the four knight defense. And here I used to play the d4 variation in the four knights defense. So one of the main variation is either d4, or the other main variation of this opening is bishop to b5, and this is the Spanish variation of the four knights defense. Okay, I'm go for the d4. He will take, and black's main move here is simply take on d4. And I also have an official FIDE rating in chess. My FIDE ELO rating is about 1200, so I'm considered to be a beginner in chess. And, I have been playing chess since I was 5. Okay, so this is the main move here, and as you can see, this is the four knights opening, as I told you earlier, and this is the scotch variation of the four knight defense, and the main move here is retake the pawn, and black's main move here is bishop to b5. So the main move here is bishop to c5. And my opponent is Orin, 1230 ELO point player from the Chessmaster Grandmaster Edition game. And Orin, I think Orin is quite good. Okay, so he decides for taking, and Orin's style is quite undecided. Okay, so I'm going to simply retake. Okay, I think so this was not the best move by black. With this queen recapturing move, white is a bit better here. Okay, so now white is a bit better because black didn't opt for this bishop to c5 move, which is now impossible. So white is a little bit better here, and you can see the time situation on the right side of the board. So this is a 30 minutes game. Each of us has 30 minutes to play for the whole game. Okay, so Orin's style is Orin is described in the Chessmaster Grandmaster Edition game. So Orin is quite an undecided player. So this means that Orin usually plays random moves against me, and he is going for bishop to e7, which is quite a passive move. So black is preparing castle short, I think. Okay. Okay, I'm going for a simple development. I'm going for bishop to c4 because this is a developing move, and I'm also prepared for castle. So I suspect that black is going for castle short. Now. And one of the most important thing might be that you can choose many personalities to play with in this game. And Orin, and in my opinion, Orin is definitely one of the opponent who can play very well. So you definitely should play very carefully against Orin. And the other crucial thing against Orin that you have to play quite fast, because so the main thing here is that you have to play quite you have to make quite fast decisions when you play against Orin, otherwise you will simply lost on time, which happened in the previous game against Orin. Okay, black plays bishop to b4, pinning my knight, and I think that this wasn't a great move, because this is because the black bishop moves again. So I simply castle. Okay. So if he takes my knight, I simply recapture with the queen is, and this is perfect for me. Okay. So my main move would be here would be, I think, bishop to g5, pinning this knight, pinning the black knight on c6. So I think white has an edge here. Okay. I have been playing chess since I was 6. I learned to play chess at the age of 5. Yes. Okay. So now my opponent is thinking. Mm-hmm. Okay. So this is a rapid game in the Chessmaster Grandmaster Edition. Okay, d6. D6 makes the way of this black c8 bishop, and now I would like to develop my last minor piece, maybe bishop to g5 would be my move, pinning this knight. Pinning this knight. Because after this move, black blocks the bishop way back to the between the queen and the knight, and this knight. So bishop to g5, so my plan would be bishop to g5 here, pinning this knight, and then I'm planning capture this knight, and if he recapture with his queen, I capture his queen, and as a result of this plan, black will be an isolated double pawn, and black also won't able to castle kingside, so this bishop to g5 move is, I think it's quite good for me. Okay, let's go for it. Okay, now he attacks my queen. Okay, this is a quite good move. Quite a good move. Okay. Okay. Okay, I simply choose back to D1. Okay. I didn't expect this bishop c5, but I choose to queen to d1 because my plan is queen to f3, attacking this knight, because capturing this knight would be a great possibility for me. But after, for example, queen to f3, black has the move bishop d4, which is, I think it's a great move, because after bishop, after black moves bishop to d4, I don't have this weakening power. Okay, c5 is quite logically preferring, black prefers to the move d5. Okay. So after, for example, queen to f3, after queen to f3, black's best move is bishop to d4, I think. Okay. And after bishop to d4, he also has the possibility to capture my knight on c4, on c3. Okay. Okay. Or I also could have played a simple development move, rook to e1. Rook to e1 and then e5. This is another possibility. Okay, let's go for rook to e1. So my plan is e5. Maybe. Okay, but after e5, I don't think that he will give up his queen. Yes. Queen e5, defending this e5 move. Because after retake, the queen is defending this pawn. Okay. Okay. This is interesting. Is interesting. Okay, then I will go for. I think in this situation with the black queen on e7, I would go for queen to f3. Queen to f3. And with queen to f3, my rooks are connected. Queen to f3, maybe bishop to g4. Takes. Okay. I would go for queen to f3, but now black has this annoying bishop to g5, this move, bishop to g5, and I think my opponent will play this bishop to g5 move, and this is and this will result a quite sharp variation. So I think black's move now will be bishop to g4. And another thing against I think one of the hardest factor or the hardest thing against a computer player that you have to be very careful with time, because timing is very important. So I only have 30 minutes, and this is only move 12, and I left about 25. No, not developing the bishop. Not developing the bishop. But why? Is this trick? This would be a trick. For example, if I take the black knight on f6, he will retake with the pawn and this row with this rook to g5 move. Black has a very powerful attack against my king, so this is a bit annoying for me. So this variation wouldn't be perfect for me. This is interesting. So now bishop takes f6 wouldn't be my best choice, because black has this half open g5 on my king. Could be dangerous for me. Oh my god. Okay, I have to play now something. So this is the course playing against the computer. Or maybe I would take this knight, and if and when he retakes, I play for g3. This could be good. g3. So bishop takes, he retakes with the pawn, and I play g3, and this could be good for me or not. But I will have this weakened ft square. And of course black will have the bishop pair. This is another thing. No. So I am thinking about taking this c6 knight would be the best decision, or replace the bishop, or move the bishop back to e3, I don't know. But move the bishop back to e3 is quite a passive move, I think. But if I take, black has the bishop there. Takes, retakes, then g3. But this c5 bishop is quite strong. I don't know. I don't think that take the c6 knight would be a great choice for me now. But after bishop back to e3, he has this bishop b5 move, which is quite annoying for me. So I'm already trouble with him. Okay, I risk. I take the risk. Okay, let's take. So Orin is described as a quite quite an undecided player. So this means that Orin makes random moves most of the time. But I think Orin is quite a good player. Okay, he retake with the queen. Now my life is easy because I change queens. So changing queens is always, is always a good decision against a computer player. And now, okay, so this is much more preferable for white. Now I'm thinking about queen to king to h1, but after king to h1 he simply would take this f3 pawn. Okay, so okay. Let's take, I go for, g3, then king to g2, and I will, and after king to g2, I will have this f3 move. Okay, I'm just a little bit, I think, because black now has this ugly isolated double pawn, which is which could be a target for me. But on the other hand, black has the bishop pair, which is very good for black. So I don't know. I think this position is quite equal. Okay. Now I wouldn't like to capture this bishop because after bishop takes black would correct his pawn chain again. So I don't like to play this move. Okay. Bishop to d3 wouldn't be very good. Thanks. Okay, let bishop back to c1, planning this, and I'm planning bishop to g2. I think bishop to g2 is, the g2 square is perfect, my bishop, I hope at least. And this and my f2 pawn is still pinned by the black bishop, so I really would like to rid of this ugly black bishop because the black bishop here is perfect. Maybe my plan is bishop to g2, then rook e to d1, and I'm happy with my position. Maybe. So please give us a thumb up if you like this video, and also subscribe. And also hit the subscribe button below the video. Okay, bishop to g. It isn't a very, okay, bishop to the reason behind bishop to g2 is that I cannot play bishop a to d1 because of this bishop. Okay. Okay, here. Here h3 bishop h5 g4 bishop to bishop back to f3. Okay. Okay, I really would like to get rid of this bishop. Okay, I really hope that this move is okay for me, but this h3 looks like a bit risky for white, but I don't know. So one annoying move could be bishop to f3, but if he plays bishop to f3, I play bishop to d2, and I force him to change the bishop, and after the black bishop pair is disappearing, I am happy with my position. So if I somehow can rid of this, yeah, the bishop retreats, and now I would like to attack somehow, but I have to be fast. Okay. Okay. Unpinning this f2 pawn. And then planning f4. Maybe. And I'm also planning rook a to d1, centralizing my rooks. Or maybe bishop to b4 is quite nice. Would be quite a nice. Yes, bishop to b4. Just as I said, just as I told you. And I really don't know that if I play rook to e3 would be a great move or not. Okay, unpinning, and I really would like to avoid capturing with the pawn, because I also would have this ugly isolated pawns, ugly isolated double pawns on the c file. Okay, then let's. Okay, let's question his bishop. Let's question his bishop. So now he will either retreat or either capture my knight. But if he capture my knight, I would be very happy with recapturing my rook, because if I somehow could eliminate his bishop pair, this would be yes. He capturing with rook, very good. Okay, so now I am better. I am better because my pawn structure is much better than his, and this d6 pawn will be a target for me. So my next move will be rook to d1, and this. And this black d6 pawn will be a target. So now, if I haven't make a serious mistake, I think I'm winning. I really hope I'm winning. But bishop to c4 would be also maybe yes. Bishop to e6, preparing this d5 move. Okay. Okay, let's go for. Let's go for F4. But after F4, he has this F5 move. I would play F5 as black, and yes, again he would correct his isolated his two isolated pawns. Yes. Okay. So now as black, I would play F5. I left 11 minutes. But if he plays F5, I would play E5, and after takes, I also would have this isolated pawn. Yeah, F5, just as I said to you, just as I told you. Yes. Or maybe I could try maybe rook to d1. Okay, let's try. Let's try. Okay, let's try rook to d1. Let's activate my other rook. So rook to d1, rook to e1. Sorry, rook to e1. So the idea now, if he takes, he would remain this isolated F7, this isolated weak F7 pawn could be a target, so I think I'm better now. And if he takes, I retake with the rook, and this bishop would also get a great target with this pin for the uncastled black knight, the uncastled black king, sorry. So yes, takes. Okay. I simply take, pinning this bishop, pinning his bishop, and okay. He go out from the pin. Okay. Then maybe. Ah, okay. So black's the threat here is this bishop to d5 move, and this would pin my knight to the king. And I also can't play bishop to c4 because of this fork. Okay, so I have to be very careful here. My king is out of the way of the pin. So with this move I defend this pin from the bishop. Okay, so when you are playing against Orin, you should be very careful and very fast, and also very fast, because one of the hardest thing when you are playing with Orin is you have to be very careful. Okay, let's go back. So now he is attack. And my plan also would be g4 then f5, and this is a great pawn chain for me. Maybe. Okay, my piece is quite a bit passive against the computer. So Orin is quite a good player, and the elo points of Orin don't. Please don't confuse you the elo points of Orin, because he's only a 1200 elo points player, but he's quite good. Yeah. Okay then. Okay, I would play for doubling. Maybe. Okay, let's double. Okay, and we play maybe later c3, and my pawns on the queen on the queen side wouldn't be a target for the black bishop. Okay. Okay. So he plays this. Offering the rook trade. I think I will win with the pawn majority on the king side if I attack these two, because these two black pawns on the king side are very weak. So after I take the rooks, both rooks, I will win with this majority. So this is the winning for me. Okay, let's trade. Let's trade the two rooks. Okay. And when he recapture, I simply play c3. Okay, and he cannot attack my pawns with his bishop. Okay, and now I am trying to activate my bishop, and I think I will win with this majority, with this pawn majority. Now I think black has this bishop back to b6, maybe. Bishop back to b6 would be... No! No bishop back. Then I am trying to trap his bishop. Maybe push! Maybe push is an option here. Okay, and now I'm just trying to exchange my bishop, and then I will win with this majority, with this pawn majority on the king side. What? He takes my pawn? Okay, then I simply retake, and now I am winning because I have this bishop. Okay, this was... I don't understand this move. Now I am totally winning, and this 7.5 minutes is more than enough for winning now. And now I have this bishop. I have the whole bishop advantage, because he clearly gives up his bishop for uncleared reason. Okay, and this is winning for me. Okay, let's activate my bishop. Okay, this is winning for white, clearly. So if you like this match, so this match is quite solid play against the computer. He gives up clearly his bishop. This was obviously a mistake. And this was obviously a gift for me. Okay, now I started to centralize my king, and also and now simply I am simply planning to attack this h6 pawn with my king. And after bishop to f5, I'm totally winning. So this is a clearly winning for white. Okay, then I will take your h-pawn. And this pawn structure on the queen side is very important, because I think this is very good for white. Okay. I think black's only move is would be b5 here, but no. Okay, then I attack your pawn. Maybe he will obviously play king to g7. Then I go Bishop to f5. So this is quite an easy game, yes. Quite an easy game. Okay. Okay. Plays really well. Now bishop to c8, b6. See b6, bishop to b7, c6. Takes, and this would be a fast pawn. Let me think a little bit. Okay, and I will time to back my bishop here. So this, I think this, I really hope that this will work. Yes. Now, just as I told you, d5, take, and my bishop is just in time. No! Then I will take your pawn. Okay, and this is completely winning for me. Okay, I simply take his dangerous d5 pawn, and his h6 pawn is also under attack. Or I maybe sacrifice my bishop. So, and now I sacrifice my bishop for his two pawns. So let's take it. So bishop f5, sacrifice my bishop for the two pawns, and this is clearly a total winning for black because I have two passed pawns. Okay, this is totally winning for white for me. Okay, push. Okay, push. And in this situation, I have to be play king to h7 to secure my pawn's pass to promote for queens. Yeah, and now I simply retake here. Okay, and now this is totally winning. For white. Yeah, I simply take, and he cannot push because I also take his pawn. Okay, so this is totally winning for me. Push. Okay, give me the queen. I have the queen. And I simply have this check and winning his pawn. Okay, and this is a very easy win for white, winning for me. Okay, and now when this is the situation, you have to be very careful not to stalemate your opponent. Push. Okay, give here. Push. And this is a mate in 2. 1, 2. Okay, so that white wins, fantastic, okay. So, thank you very much for watching me. Please like, subscribe to my channel, and see you on the next video.